In an era of shifting global threats and sophisticated adversaries, the U.S. Navy stands guard on the world's oceans. At the forefront of America's missile defense lies a remarkable shield, an integrated system called Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense. Designed to intercept missiles hurtling through the atmosphere, Aegis BMD is more than just technology. It's a strategic bulwark, one that protects U.S. allies and forces around the globe. But how does this complex network of warships, interceptors, and onshore sites actually work? And why has it become one of the most critical tools in America's defense arsenal? The origins of a legendary shield. The name Aegis traces back to Greek mythology, a fabled shield used by Zeus. For the Navy, Aegis is a nod to a protective network that began its life in the 1970s as an advanced ship combat system aimed at defending vessels from aircraft and cruise missiles. Initially deployed on Ticonderoga-class cruisers in the early 1980s, Aegis integrated sensors, computers, software, and weapon launchers into a seamlessly coordinated system. Over the decades, the Navy discovered that Aegis could do more than simply protect ships. With the right upgrades, powerful radars, advanced software, and specialized interceptors, it could track and knock down ballistic missiles high above Earth, turning an already formidable shield into a global ballistic missile defense asset. Enter ballistic missile defense. In recent decades, nations such as Iran and North Korea have made strides in ballistic missile technology. The threat of these missiles, capable of traveling thousands of miles in mere minutes, prompted the U.S. to expand its missile defense umbrella. The result, the Aegis Ballistic Missile Defense Program, executed by the Missile Defense Agency, MDA, in partnership with the Navy. BMD-capable Aegis ships now patrol critical theaters like the Mediterranean Sea to safeguard European allies and the Western Pacific to deter North Korean missile attacks. Over time, the number of these ships has grown steadily. According to the MDA, 49 Aegis BMD-capable ships existed in late 2023. That figure is expected to increase to 56 by fiscal year 2025 and potentially reach 69 by fiscal year 2030. Anatomy of an Aegis BMD ship, the heart of Aegis, spy, radar, and combat system. What makes an Aegis ship so effective? It begins with the Aegis combat system, a high-powered radar, historically Spy 1, evolving now to SY-6 on the new Flight 3 Arleigh Burke destroyers that sweeps the skies in search of threats. Linked by advanced fire control computers, the system can track and engage multiple incoming missiles at once, guiding interceptor missiles to their targets with pinpoint precision. Cruisers and destroyers. The Navy's Ticonderoga, CG-47 class cruisers, and Arleigh Burke, DDG-51 class destroyers form the core of this Aegis fleet. A substantial number of older Ticonderogas have now retired or are slated for retirement, while Arleigh Burkes, numbering over 90 procured, continually enter service, many built from the keel up with ballistic missile defense in mind. As of today, most new BMD additions hail from these cutting-edge destroyers, each bristling with vertical launch cells for interceptors and other missiles. Beyond the ship, Aegis Ashore. Aegis technology isn't confined to the seas. In a concept known as Aegis Ashore, the exact same radar, computers, and missiles are housed on land. Two such sites, one in Romania, the other in Poland, aim to defend Europe from ballistic missiles. This land-based adaptation was part of the European Phased Adaptive Approach, EPADA, a strategy designed to protect NATO allies against potential Iranian missile threats. The Romanian site became operational in 2016, but the Polish site faced years of construction delays. Ultimately completed in late 2023, it became fully mission ready in mid-2024, marking a major milestone. Although the U.S. Navy mans and operates these sites, top Navy leaders have expressed that this land defense mission might be more appropriate for ground forces, a debate that continues in Washington. The missiles themselves, SM-3 and SM-6. SM-3, mid-course interceptor animation of an SM-3 missile, launching vertically from a ship. The rocket ascends, jettisons stages, and then the kill vehicle separates to collide with a target outside Earth's atmosphere. At the core of Aegis BMD is the Standard Missile 3, SM-3. Its purpose, intercept ballistic missiles in the mid-course phase, well above the atmosphere. With no explosive warhead, the SM-3 uses hit-to-kill technology, relying on sheer kinetic energy to obliterate the threat. Successive variants, Block IA, Block IB, and Block IIA have improved range, guidance, and propulsion. The Block 2IA, co-developed with Japan, is larger in diameter and can engage higher, faster threats. In some scenarios, the SM-3 has even demonstrated an ability, under test conditions, to destroy intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, sparking discussions about whether it could augment homeland defense. SM-6, Terminal Interceptor. For lower altitude interceptions, the Navy turns to the SM-6, a multi-mission missile adept at both air defense and ballistic missile defense in the terminal final phase of a missile's flight. Its versatility is a key advantage, letting ships defend against aircraft, cruise missiles, and ballistic threats with one unified weapon system. Future variants, like SM-6 Block YB, could feature a larger rocket motor for extended range and improved speed, crucial in an era of hypersonic threats. Forward position guardians. Rota, Spain. To safeguard Europe, four BMD-capable Arleigh Burke destroyers have been based at Rota, Spain, since 2014 to 2015. The strategic advantage is clear. Stationing ships in European waters cuts transit time, expands coverage, and reduces the total number of ships needed to maintain persistent ballistic missile defense. In 2022, the Biden administration announced plans to expand Rota-based forces to six BMD-capable destroyers, an initiative set to materialize by the mid-2020s. The Western Pacific and Gulf regions. Even as Europe sees an expanded naval footprint, the Western Pacific remains a hotbed for ballistic missile threats, particularly from North Korea. Aegis ships also frequently transit the Persian Gulf to guard against Iranian missiles. In total, the demand for Aegis BMD platforms far outstrips supply, pushing the Navy to accelerate modernization and push new destroyers into the fleet. The testing regime, trials and triumphs. In missile defense, testing is paramount. Flight trials confirm that radars, missiles, and command systems work under real-world conditions, inclement weather, cluttered radar environments, and stressful timelines. The Aegis BMD program follows a build a little, test a little, learn a lot approach, a philosophy that underscores iterative progress. In November 2020, the Aegis system made headlines by successfully intercepting an ICBM representative target using an SM-3 block OEI. While not all tests go perfectly, each attempt yields critical data. Moreover, the recent success in 2024 with an operational kill chain from Hawaii across the Pacific underscores how far Aegis BMD has come and how crucial it is for deterrence. Issues on the horizon, congressional debates. Annual funding battles Congress plays a key role in shaping the Aegis BMD program. The Missile Defense Agency's budget for fiscal year 2024 requests around $1.3 billion for procurement, R&D, and sustainment, including funds for the two Aegis Ashore sites in Europe. Lawmakers scrutinize these figures, balancing them against competing defense priorities and the broader U.S. fiscal environment, homeland defense versus regional missions. A crucial debate centers on whether Aegis BMD should extend beyond regional defense to protect the U.S. homeland against ICBMs. Successfully intercepting an ICBM during a test was a monumental proof of concept, but is it practical or cost-effective to rely on naval ships for homeland defense? Some argue for dedicated ground-based interceptors, freeing up the Navy's multi-mission vessels for other critical tasks. The burden on the fleet. Another pivotal question. Should the Navy continue stationing its prized Aegis warships in narrow zones, waiting to intercept ballistic missiles? Many leaders, including top admirals, say such static missions sap the fleet's agility. They suggest building additional land-based sites, like Aegis Ashore, to shoulder more of the burden, freeing ships to roam the seas and perform other missions. Allied burden sharing ballistic missile defense is not a solo act. Japan, for instance, operates 8, soon to be 10, BMD-capable Aegis destroyers. Allies like Spain, Norway, South Korea, and Australia field Aegis-equipped ships, though not always BMD-capable. The question is, are these allies shouldering enough responsibility in global missile defense? Some in Congress wonder if more allied involvement, both financial and operational, should be required. Future technologies, from lasers to hypersonics. Ship-based lasers. One promising frontier is ship-based lasers, which could one day provide a lower-cost means of intercepting short- and medium-range missiles in the terminal phase. Such directed energy weapons might also reduce the need to stockpile large inventories of SM interceptors, though significant technical challenges remain. Countering hypersonic threats. Hypersonic missiles maneuver at extreme speeds, posing new interception hurdles. The Missile Defense Agency is pursuing a glide phase intercept, GPI concept, an SM-type interceptor designed to strike threats in mid-flight. Integrating such capabilities onto Aegis platforms would greatly expand the Navy's repertoire against the next generation of advanced weapons. Aegis around the world, Japan, a key partner. Japan stands out as a vital ally in the Aegis BMD realm, co-developing the SM-3 Block 2IA and fielding its own BMD-capable Aegis destroyers. Initially, Tokyo planned 2 Aegis Ashore sites but shifted to building additional BMD-capable ships instead. Once these new vessels enter service in the late 2020s, they'll bolster regional defense against threats from North Korea and beyond. South Korea, Australia, and other South Korea fields, modern Aegis destroyers, though not all are BMD-enabled. However, the country recently announced plans to acquire SM-3 interceptors, a sign of evolving regional security concerns. Australia, Spain, and Norway also operate Aegis ships, but their BMD capabilities vary, highlighting the incremental spread of ballistic missile defense technology among U.S. partners. Challenges and the road ahead. Like any large-scale defense program, Aegis BMD faces challenges, rising costs, scheduling slips, and the complexities of future technologies. As flight tests progress, the program must refine new interceptors while keeping older missiles in service. MDA cost estimates and transparency remain a perennial congressional focus, as does the question of how best to measure program success. Many see Aegis BMD as a linchpin for national and regional missile defense for decades to come. However, the U.S. Navy, and indeed the entire Department of Defense, wrestles with how to balance near-term missions against emerging threats like hypersonics. As the world's geopolitical landscape evolves, the demands on Aegis BMD will only intensify. The unyielding shield. For more than 4 decades, Aegis has been America's shield at sea, evolving with each new challenge. Today, as ballistic and hypersonic missile threats loom large, Aegis BMD stands ready on ships stationed across the globe, in land-based sites in Europe, and perhaps one day in new architectures around Guam or elsewhere. Its core mission is straightforward yet profoundly complex: to ensure that missiles, no matter their range or origin, never reach their intended targets. Congressional leaders, military planners, and allied partners all share in charting the next course. Do we build more Aegis Ashore sites or rely on ships? Do we further extend Aegis into homeland-wise CBM defense? Above all, do we invest enough to stay ahead of emerging technologies that threaten to outrun our current interceptors? Amid questions of strategy, cost, and ship availability, one thing remains certain. The Aegis BMD program has become a symbol of America's commitment to protect not just its fleet, but partners worldwide. In an unpredictable world, Aegis stands as the Navy's watchful guardian, a testament to human ingenuity in pursuit of security for the seas and well beyond.